Ora, recapitulation. We start from the flow sheet with the regenerative heat exchanger in place, but without the detailed exchangers from Aspen heat exchanger design and rating. Okay, only the regenerative with the block M heat X. Cut the detailed heat exchangers if you have any in the flow sheet. Then we turn the equilibrium columns in rate-based columns. For the styrene columns, the specifications are these. Renato, start from here before checking anything else.
Yes. This is our rate-based column.
The first.
Yes, 11. Okay. Specifications.
The condenser you can leave as it were.
Yes,
as it
without
were.
The utility.
Okay. Then you have to adjust the variables in the design specification, Simone, to
sì.
enlarge
sì.
the limits.
Sì, fatto.
Then these are the inputs for the Mellapack sections. The section should cover all the fictitious stages.
Non me li sto copiando dal mio coso.
Whatever. And these are the specification for the section. Now I check if the base stage was chosen properly after running the simulation. Okay. The vapor flow is nearly constant over all the section. So you can choose whatever base stage you want. There is a very little difference above the feed and below the feed. Any base stage will do. Ok, per la cronaca, these are the hydraulic plots. Allora, just consider one thing. You see that my column is a little too wide. You see that the operating point is always relatively low in this graph. Don't worry. Because in the course of this workshop, we will vary the column feed and the column reflux ratio. Especially increasing the feed and increasing the reflux ratio. So it's good to have a little margin in this moment. Now, for the second column, the specification are a little bit more complex because we had two sections. Allora, so calma e gesso. The bottom to feed ratio should be brought to 0.8 by default.
Okay.
Okay. Allora, the design specification, for the moment, it's better to disable them, just for this moment.
Va bene.
Because I will show you I will show you after because we have to disable this specification for now. Allora.
non è contento.
Don't worry, Simone. If you have doubts, copy from my schermo.
No, adesso devo capire cosa non gli piace ad Aspen. Ah, che non ho le licenze perché ho attivo l'antivirus.
Ok, questa parte la taglierò. No, mannaggia. Ok, this is done. No, cos'è che vuole ancora? Che mi manca? Ah, ok. I should check the arrangement of the seed trays.
Sembra andare, gira senza disagi.
Ok, bene.
Hydraulic plots sono a posto.
Pay attention when you specify yes. The sieve trays.
Tanto okay. Scusa, come mod dobbiamo mettere interactive sizing o lasciare rating?
It's better that you put rating if you copy just the values.
Ok.
Interactive sizing is a shortcut to let Aspen calculate the column interna.
Okay.
Non sono sicuro di saper leggere il grafico degli hydraulic plots per capire cosa mi sta dicendo.
Adesso vediamo un attimo.
Cioè non è che mi dà errore, però vorrei sapere cos'è.
Ah, non ti dà errore, ma ti dà un warning, tipo?
Sì, esatto.
Allora, adesso correggo una cosa nel mio flowsheet, poi me lo proietti a schermo.
Mm-hmm.
No, I remember that film reaction is useless in our case. It's better to put consider film because we don't have reactions.
Okay.
Allora, the calculation is more or less the same perché Aspen is forced to calculate the film in both the cases. Nevertheless, this is a clean specification. Allora, I check if there are problems. No. Allora, in my case, everything seems in order. Allora, the first thing to do now, guys, is to specify the hot and cold utilities for the non-regenerative heat exchangers. Number one, number two, number three, number four, and the column, the number 10, the boiler, and the columns. So, allora, you go here, you see this tab, utilities.
Utilities?
Sì, dico, la vedete?
Sì. Yes.
Ok. New. Allora, the first utilities we need is the cooling water. Select tank che select also copy from.
Okay. Che cosa fa la funzione copy from?
When you tell Aspen copy from blah blah blah, the program fills these options with default values.
Okay.
Because otherwise you would have to input all these values on your own.
Okay.
While it is pretty handy that Aspen Plus already fills this form with its own values.
Okay, then.
Yes.
Okay. Allora, nevertheless, we do some modification here. Allora, I will not touch anything related to the money. Mm-hmm. Because for this workshop, I didn't made a research on the actual prices of this utility now. So I will trust the default values by Aspen.
Mm-hmm.
Nevertheless, I touch some heat exchange values. For example, here you can put 750 watt square meter Kelvin.
Okay.
In let outlet, these values are good enough for me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, a second type of cooling utility is air. Copy from air. Okay. See the task specify zero as the utility cost. Because actually air is not, you don't have to buy air. Air yes. is there. You just need to have the fan to let air flow. But the fan is a capital expense, not an operative expense.
Okay.
Allora, in this case, we can use 15 because it's air enforced convection. Okay, with these two types of utility, we could do, I guess, all the cooling that we need. Because the lower temperature of our process stream is 40 degrees. We don't need anything colder than the cooling water. Pronto? Allora, when it comes to heating, the picture is quite different. Because we need to heat up our process stream at different temperature levels. For example, you see that we have the reaction mixture that is needed to be heat up at more than 600 degrees. While, for example, the boilers in the columns have a relative low temperature. The reaction mixture needs to be heated at more than 600 degrees. While, for example, the boilers of the column have a much lower temperature. So also in this case, we have to define multiple heating utilities.
Mm-hmm.
So, allora, high temperature heat, copy from fired heat. Ok. This is a typical combustion flue gas. Allora, we just touch also in this case the heat transfer coefficient. For a combustion flue gas, we can use 50.
L'hai preso da HP Steam? No, quella è il pressure.
Fired heat.
Ah, fired heat. 1000? 1000, immagino, sì.
Sì. Ok. Now, this fired heat will be good to supply heat to heat exchanger 1, heat exchanger 2, and... maybe also the boiler. Okay.
Okay.
It won't be good to supply heat here. Because you see that the foreseen temperatures are from 1000 to 400. While here between the two reactors, the temperature is never so low as 400. So I have to define also a twin utility. IT heat for the reactor. Allora, it's always a fired heat 1000, but I change the lower temperature.
Okay.
So in this case, the program will be forced to use a higher flow rate of this flue gas. Now we need some middle temperature heat source for the columns. Then we will choose how to use for the boiler. So, medium pressure steam, of course. We check the temperatures. Okay. Ah, the heat transfer coefficient. Allora, it's a condensing fluid. We can use the heat transfer coefficient as high as 2000. Okay, now the last. Low pressure steam. We check the temperatures. Okay. Also in this case, we can use 2000.
Okay.
Now, we simply browse all the non-regenerative heat exchanger in the flow sheet. And we go to the tab utility and we pick up a proper utility.
Okay.
Allora, for heat exchanger 1, high temperature heat. because I have to go from 200 to 630. Pretty simple.
Yes.
For the HX2, the same. The number 3 instead, it's the high temperature modified. Because in this case, we have between 590 and 600 and something more. Okay. Now, okay. It is changer number 4. For me, it's a cooler. Allora, guys, in this case, you can use or cooling water or air, as you want. Mi seguite?
Yes.
Okay. Also for heat exchanger number 10, it is your choice whether to use water or air.
Okay.
Pronto?
Ok,
vado di acqua.
Allora, remember that water is not as cheap as air. Mm-hmm. But it has a higher heat transfer coefficient, so it will result in a more compact heat exchanger. So, in reality, if you choose air, you will have less operative expenses and higher capital expenses. If you choose water, you will have higher operative expenses and less capital expenses.
Because air, we require more air.
No, Renato.
You require more surface area.
Require, esatto, a higher.
Okay, expense. Yes, okay.
So, in this case, pick up what you want. We can modify the stuff also later.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Allora, I will tell you what I will do, but it's just my decision. Eh? At this stage, guys, you already can be free to do what you want and see the results of your choice. Allora, I will use air here and here. Because I have a higher delta T. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
But here and here, where the temperature difference is lower, I will go for water. Nevertheless, we are already in, okay, it is not mandatory.
Eccoli qua. Per le colonne abbiamo detto
allora, medium pressure. For the column, allora, you have to go inside the column. Allora, you pick up the condenser.
Okay.
Allora, in the second column, I will use air. The second column. The tip benzene recovery column. While for the reboiler, I will use medium pressure steam. Instead, the first column, the column that purifies the styrene, I will use water in the condenser, because the condenser is at a lower temperature. For the reboiler, I will use low pressure steam. Now, Agen needs to decide which kind of hot utility use for the boiler. The boiler is at a relatively low pressure. This is the boiler of the recycled condensate.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Allora, in theory, for this boiler, we can use or the fire the heat or the medium pressure steam. Allora, usually the boilers, guys, are heated with the fired heat, not with the other steam. Okay? Nevertheless, in this particular case, you have the choice open. Allora, I will start using high temperature heat.
Okay.
Allora, you should not have any problem in running the simulation also now. The question is, the styrene produced is a revenue. Okay. While the energy required in the hot utility and the cold utility is the cost. Is the cost.
Okay.
Okay. What is the best combination of process parameters that maximize the revenues and minimize the cost?
So, an energy optimization?
No, not exactly. A cost, an operational cost optimization. An optimization.
Okay, so we are working on the heat exchangers.
Mainly.
To better optimize the heat.
I selected a space of 4 process variables to modify.
Mm-hmm.
Allora, the first process variable to modify is the inlet pressure of the reactor. Because, it's rather simple, because the reaction kinetic is expressed of starting from the partial pressures.
Okay.
The second process variable to touch is the temperature between the two reactors. The reaction is endothermal, so after the first stage, I need to reheat. I want to check if reheating to a certain level instead of another as an effect of the overall cost.
Can you repeat?
E praticamente tra uno stadio di reazione e l'altra io devo riscaldare di nuovo la miscela reagente perché la reazione è endotermica.
Mm-hmm.
Scaldando però tu fai correre anche le reazioni parassite. Quindi ti viene il dubbio che non è che magari scaldare troppo non ha un effetto detrimente, oltre a consumare più energia termica.
Tu dici, se scaldi troppo si abbassa la selettività?
Lo voglio vedere, capisci?
Ok.
Allora, the other process variable that I have selected is the quantity of recycled fuel benzene. If I manipulate the bottom to feed ratio of the second column, I can recycle more or less a reacted ethyl benzene.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then the last process variable that I may want to touch is the steam quantity. Because more steam means lower partial pressures of the chemicals. And so less styrene production, but also less parasite reactions. Two competing mechanisms. And so I identify also these process variables as having a potential effect on the overall cost.
Mm-hmm.
I want to search the best combination of these process variables with Aspen.
Okay.
Allora, the procedure is this. Open the menu optimization on your left.
Okay.
Sei?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, here in the define, we have to define all the process variables to be monitored.
Mm-hmm.
Allora, the first, more obvious, is the styrene production. Okay.
Aspetta, io devo far girare probabilmente la simulazione una volta?
No, non è necessario.
Non ci sono già i dati dentro, tipo i results sono vuoti.
Non fa niente.
Niente?
Perché questo drag and drop ti serve solo a definirti le variabili in una maniera più corta, mm-hmm. ma non è necessario. Te la puoi definire anche nel metodo classico. Variabili, styrene, il nome glielo dai tu e poi ti fai tutta l'altra fila. Stream, mol flow, il nome dello stream, eccetera.
Hai ragione.
Then I need also the mole flow of ethylbenzene in the feed because I have to discount my product for the feed. Quindi andiamo a prendercelo.
L'inlet di...
Si chiama 10 feed l'inlet stream.
E che parametro vogliamo prendere?
Il mole flow. Riesci a vedere sul mio schermo come sto definendo le variabili?
Which fit mixed ethyl benzene.
Ale, lo vedi nel mio schermo?
Mm-hmm. Ci sono.
Ok. Then I have to load all the cost of the hot and cold utilities. So, I just have to browse through the various heat exchangers. Allora, new. HX1 cost, block variable, heat exchanger number one. Variable utility cost. You see, it's already in dollars per hour. Mm-hmm. Once you have defined the first, you just copy and paste. Then, for the pasted variables, you just modify the name and the block. Mi segui?
No, ho cercato un attimo.
Ti sei chiuso?
Mi si stava per chiudere, per fortuna non mi si è chiuso. Però non ho fatto niente.
Sei riuscito a definire l'utility cost per il primo heat exchanger?
Sì.
Adesso fai copia e incolla. Poi cambi il nome e cambi l'heat exchanger di afferenza dopo aver fatto il copia e incolla.
Ok.
Per vedere quali sono gli heat exchanger non rigenerativi, te li vedi sul flow sheet. Sono l'1, il 2, il 3, il 4 e il 10.
Ok.
Dovresti avere una cosa fatta così.
Sì, a parte il fatto, sì, ce l'ho una roba fatta così. Uno, due, tre, quattro, dieci.
Quando ce ne hai tutti, vado avanti, perché ne dobbiamo aggiungere altri, ma non un po' diverso.
Ci sono.
Ok, then there is the steam generator that is called boiler. So, new SG cost. Allora, the block is called boiler and the variable is always the utility cost. Okay. Okay, then we have to add the condenser and the reboilers of the distillation column. So in this case, the syntax is a little bit different. Allora, condenser one cost. But this is just the name. Allora, the problem is that the search in the distillation column parameters is a little bit length. Mm-hmm. Allora, for the condenser of a column, you have to pick up cond UTL cost. And you do the same for the column number 2, cioè la numero 21.
Mm-hmm.
E poi lo stesso per il reboiler, però per il reboiler non è cond UTL cost, ma è rebl UTL cost o reb. Allora, once you completed the list, save. Ok, quando ci sei dimmelo. Ti lascio fuori la tendina aperta così puoi controllare.
Mm. No, ma... Ah, che bello, mi è comparsa la tendina. No, ma c'è tutto, direi. Aspetta, fa controllare, stiri. Ok, sì, ci sono.
Ok. Now, the process variables that we want to manipulate. Very new. Allora, the first is the inlet pressure before the reactor. So it's the block var of mix 2 pressure. And we go from 2 bars to 4 bars. Step size, you will choose. Mm-hmm. Okay, then the temperature after the regeneration, after the first stage of reactor. So, block var, pick up exchanger number 3. Temperature. Okay, from 600 to 700.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then the steam injected in the cycle. Quindi, allora, it's the mol flow. Stream number 20. The component is water. Allora, from 3,000 to 4,000. Because the best case value is 3,400. Then the last, it's the bottom to feed ratio of the ethylbenzene recovery column. Quindi, variable number 4, block var, column 2-1, B2F ratio, allora, in the base case, this column works with the bottom to feed ratio of 0.8. So we go from 0.7 to 0.9. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now, at first instance, Ale, to check if the program works, disabilitate the varied variables except the number 2. Because first I want to check that the optimization work before
the
run. Esatto. Allora, mm-hmm. Now we have to add the objective function. Allora, before we need to put some Fortran code.
Mm-hmm.
Because basically we have to sum the cost of all the hot and cold utilities.
Okay.
Tu sai già mettere un po' di Fortran in Aspen?
Sì, sì, me l'hai già fatto fare. Sempre per fare delle somme di qualcosa.
Okay. So we need one variable to have the summation of the utility cost and one variable to put the summation of the material cost.
Allora, no. Mi fai vedere un attimo?
Sì, no problem.
Grazie.
The problem is that now we have to copy the names exactly. Allora, volevi vedere le declaration?
Mm-hmm.
Vabbè.
Mat cost. Ok, grazie.
Se lo vuoi chiamare Pippo, chiamalo Pippo.
Sì, beh, non so cosa ci faccio con Pippo poi, quindi devo ricordarmi.
Bravo. Allora, util cost uguale. Ok, we start in the order. Ok. When you arrive to 70 characters, break the line. Or even before. Pronto?
Pronto, sto copiando.
Beh, sì, è piuttosto banale. Devi fare una somma. Semplicemente ho aperto le tendine in parallelo perché devi copiare
più
i
veloce.
Tendini, altrimenti sono macerie.
Mm-hmm. Cos'è che dicevi sul numero di numeri?
Ho spezzato la sommatoria così perché c'è un limite di caratteri che puoi mettere in una singola riga.
Ok,
quindi se vuoi andare sul sicuro,
ah, ok,
spezza la sommatoria.
Ma maiuscolo minuscolo influisce?
No, non è così sensitive.
Ok.
Niente, scusa, mi ho già sparato nelle palle. Ok. Pronto, mi senti?
Sì, 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 sì.
Allora, now we have to add the material cost for the benzene and the material revenue for Styrene. Allora, I found on the internet some data relative to the year 2015.
Mm-hmm.
Allora, the best period for this process in that year was in the month of May. Because you see that you have a high differential between styrene and benzene.
Mm-hmm.
In that year, you in that month, you could sold styrene at 60 cents of dollar per pound and buy benzene at 45 cents of dollar per pound. So, we write like this. Allora, we start from styrene. Allora, we have the mole flows, guys. So, I have to convert in kilograms per hour and then in pounds per hour. Okay. Allora, styrene.
104.
Then I have to switch from kilograms to pounds. Yeah. Okay, it's a 2.2 factor. And then I add my selling price. Fin qui tutto ok?
Mm-hmm. Ok. Io ho 5 minuti, devo andare comunque.
Sono quelli che servono.
Perfetto.
Now you have to subtract ethyl benzene. Allora, I look up for the molar weight of ethyl benzene. The buying price was 0.45 in May 2015. Now my objective function will be simply mat cost minus util cost to maximize. Okay, we are varying only the temperature between the reaction stages. Vediamo. Ti gira?
Mm-hmm.
Ah. So, we check the results of the optimization and we see that we can earn $92 per hour if the temperature between the reaction stages is slightly lower than the base case. This is because the reactor is kinetic, is very sensitive to the temperature. Now, let's see what happens if I let vary more than one variable at a time. Okay, as a result, we can have higher revenues at lower pressures, lower temperature, and less steam in the reactor. The only point is to verify if. The small fraction of styrene in the product is compatible to avoid the autopolymerization.